Quick Connect fittings are an amazing product. They simply refer to the fact that we can connect tubing to a fitting very quickly. Introduced to our industry probably somewhere around the late 70s, early 80s, realistically revolutionized the way we put products together. And it really is as simple as a tubing applied to the fitting very quickly connects, and now we have a watertight connection. The beauty of Quick Connect fittings is the simple design. They comprise of three components: a collet, an O-ring, and the body, the fitting body. And it works simply by putting the tubing through the collet, through the O-ring, into the body of the fitting. This creates a watertight seal, and it works by, as pressure grows either through liquid or gas, air, the design of this collet body, it pushes these little grab rings into the tubing. And the harder I pull, the tighter it holds onto the tubing. And that's such a simple design, but yet so effective. The biggest problem that we run into is people don't put the tubing in quite far enough. To install a tube into a Quick Connect fitting, it's just merely a case of pushing it in and pushing it in far enough. If you don't push it in far enough and get through that O-ring, you could possibly get a leak because it's not sealing properly with that O-ring. Now, to take them apart, you pull the collet in and pull the tubing out. It's just that simple. The connection and release of tubing in these Quick Connect fittings is really the simplicity of where this collet is. When I have a tube installed and I'm trying to pull it out, the collet's working against me and it's doing what it's supposed to do. I don't know if you can see it, we'll show a close-up. The body is made so that as I pull this out, the little grab ring on this collet is biting into the tubing. Well, in order to release a tube from this, I want to pull that collet down so it won't pull out with the tubing and bite into it. So you push it in to make the seal, make the connection, and you pull that collet in and pull the tubing out to release. Quick Connect fittings are used almost anywhere we're moving water, especially for filters, under the counter point of use systems. In fact, some under counter systems like the NeoPure ultrafiltration system, they're built right in, so it makes installation a snap. They're used for a variety of OEM manufacturing, for a variety of products that move water or filter water. In fact, a lot of these fittings are also rated for pneumatic use for compressed air or some level of gas. The one thing to always be concerned about when you're using chemicals is if the chemical is compatible with the type of plastic that the material is made out of. The difference between male and female fittings is simply the thread on the male fitting is on the outside, the thread on the female fitting is on the inside. We use a couple of different terms in the industry: connectors and adapters. They really mean the same thing. They're in basically a connector. When I think of adapters, I typically think of something that's changing the venue. So I'm going from a thread to a Quick Connect connection, which would be like this stem adapter, which has a thread followed by the stem. But in all reality, they're still all connectors. They're connecting tubing with threads or vice versa. Quick Connect fittings are used all over the place, residentially, commercially. OEM manufacturers use a lot of these fittings if their product has something to do with moving liquid or air. Residential connections, certainly, for an under-counter point-of-use system, like our NeoPure ultrafiltration unit, The quick connects are built right in to make installation as easy as possible. These fittings are good for water, they're good for air. They can also be used for chemical compounds, but point of note, be sure that the plastic in the fitting is compatible with the type of chemical that you're using. Another good thing about quick connect fittings, going back to that simplistic design, is as long as we're not in an environment where we're vibrating or things are moving around a lot, this thing will stay in place. The O-ring, as long as it's a good seal, will stay a good seal. It's possible that after many, many years of service that the O-ring could dry, and that would manifest as a small little drip leak. But under normal circumstances, they're really good as long as the fitting is put together properly. One other thing that we do have in case of, let's say we're hooked up in a motorhome or we're in a boat someplace that motor vibration or on a piece of equipment with a pump, they have these little locking clips that hold the collet up so that the tubing can't come out of the fitting. So there's a variety of things that these are really great for, and in applications where we might see some vibration where the tubing could walk out, these little clips will lock the tubing in place. Quick connect fittings on occasion will leak. And the most usual reason for the leak is the tubing did not get pushed in all the way. So if upon installation, we pushed through the little collet ring, but we didn't get through the O-ring, well, that's going to leak because the seal's not there. A little trick that I tell people to do is measure 3/4 of an inch on the tube that's going to be put into the fitting and make a little line. And when you put the two pieces together, that 3/4 inch line should disappear into the fitting. Other things that can cause leaks is if we didn't cut the tubing properly, and we've got a big diagonal cut rather than a square cut, it's possible that the O-ring doesn't have a chance to seal. Another thing that can happen is that the O-ring gets lacerated. If we don't cut the tube properly and it has a sharp point on it, that sharp point could damage the O-ring, which is not going to allow the seal. Another thing that happens is side torque. I've put a piece of tubing in the fitting and now I'm going to try to bend it to get to whatever else I'm connected to, and that side torque could elongate the O-ring and create a lapse in the seal, and that will leak as well. But under normal circumstances, if the tubing is in all the way, if the O-ring is not stretched by a side torque, or I didn't damage the O-ring on inserting the tube, it should be watertight. One other thing that could happen is if I take apart and put the tube back together again frequently, if this is a fitting on a piece of equipment that I'm constantly taking apart and putting back together, eventually you could get scratches in that tubing that could be deep enough to bypass the O-ring. And that might be a good application for a quick release type fitting, which we're going to talk about at another time. Quick connect fittings are rated for pressure by temperature, also by the fitting size. The warmer the water, the lower the pressure the fitting will withstand. And that has to do with the expansion contraction of the plastics. The larger the fittings, the more rigid the tubing, the little bit more pressure we might be able to withstand. But the two have to be looked at together, pressure and temperatures, to establish exactly what the pressure limit is of these fittings. Quick connect fittings, most of them are rated for both liquid and compressed air or gas. Some of the series, some of the manufacturers are not rated for gas, water only. And you got to make sure whatever your application is, what the specs and the rating is of that particular fitting. And I've mentioned it before, the chemical compatibility is very important. For example, if you are using chlorine in your liquid, you want to make sure that the plastic of that particular fitting is compatible with whatever chemical, if it's chlorine, you're using. Tubing that you use with Quick Connect fittings is fairly important. The smaller diameter fittings that are measured by OD, or outer diameter of the tubing, is designed fairly specifically to use with LLDPE type tubing, low linear density polyethylene. They are rated to work on copper, but I would give you a little bit of advice on the copper. If you're going to be pulling it apart and putting it back together more than just a couple times, it's not necessarily a good application with copper. There are fittings made specifically for stainless steel. You want to make sure you move towards that type of a fitting. John Guest calls it super seal. The larger fittings in the half inch, three quarter inch, inch and above, those are considered CTS, or copper tube size fittings. Those are made specifically for PEX, which is also a polyethylene type tubing, but they're also pretty good with copper. And the reason that they work good is because of the locking design on the top of the fittings. When choosing a fitting for your project or your application, one consideration is the type of tubing and the size of tubing that you're using. These fittings come in two specific measurement classes. The smaller diameter tubing, like quarter inch, 3/8, even getting into some half inch, are typically OD, or outer diameter, meaning that the dimension, the outer diameter of the tubing, is how the fitting is sized. So this is a 3/8 inch OD tube, this is a 3/8 inch Quick Connect OD, and those two are compatible. When you move into the larger sized fittings, such as maybe a whole house plumbing size, 3/4 inch, some half inch, you're graduating up to the CTS size. And they're not compatible, so a 3/8 CTS is not going to work in a 3/8 OD. So when you're choosing the fittings, it's pretty important that you understand which of those classes you're dealing with.